Hello, Mr. Nealon here. Welcome back to Warcraft World War version 2.2. We're playing the combined Naga and Blood Elves hotseat campaign. So we're playing two factions. And we are about to fight a battle. It's the Naga, the Battle of the Ruins of Mathystra. As I said in the previous episode, I have fought this battle before when I streamed on Twitch. That video was deleted because videos on Twitch are deleted after a while. Plus the quality was so bad, so I would have been forced to replay it anyway. I failed at my planned Twitch stream. Let's play. I had planned on playing the game on Twitch. I even bought a device in order to do that, but I only had like 720 resolution, and I couldn't improve it, despite the device stating it would be 1080 or 1080p. Okay, so we are facing three armies of Night Elves. We looked at them in the previous episode. I believe we'll just immediately go to battle. We have three generals, Warlord Thristis, Warlord Kael'Thas, and Nayentus, a Naga Royal Guard general, an important guy that I don't want to lose. Okay, the only one that is a Naga Royal Guard. We have some others that have the Rat-Fshara model used by these two. Okay, we have an army. So let's play this battle for the third time. And now finally we will record. So the last time I played it, I managed to win. And the one time before that I had killed about 98% or something, and then it crashed. So we will try now again to win it. And the last time I played, I believe the battle took over an hour 50 minutes or something. We will see. Because the enemy has a lot of troops, they will attack with three armies, and then we will need to sally out and take care of the remnants after we have defeated the armies that try to take the city, because there will be forces outside. Okay, let's start the battle. It would be nice if we can combine the Naga and Blood Elven troops into one united front, but they are too far away from each other in Northrend, and also the other armies are in Kalimdor or in Eastern Kingdom, so they are separated by a continent. There are some armies in Northrend, and I believe one Naga army and one Blood Elven army, and they are too far away from each other at the moment. Let's start deployment. We're fighting in a Naga castle, custom settlement. It's from Hyrule Total War originally, made by Andai and Nephilim for the Lana Yuru province, the Zelda franchise, the Lana Yuru Sora. Okay, but we have new unique textures here made by Band Chieftains. We remade the texture to fit the Naga, but the settlement itself is from Hyrule Total War. Okay, now let's place out our troops. So of course we will place the sea callers on the walls, because we need them on the walls. Fire at the enemy. Okay. We will place all of them on the walls. Sea callers are really effective on the walls. They are our archers. They are casters, so they are better than ordinary archers, but they are still not as good as normal archers. Normal casters. So they are casters that work more like archers than casters. But due to their magic projectile, they are pretty OP on the walls. Okay, we will also place our Naga ambushers on the walls. Place them here, and I see something over here too. Sea callers. Don't know why they got back like that. It's like the wall is forcing them to move out position. We will, of course, place them in one group, and they will all have special ability, fire flaming ammo. When you have a caster, you need to use the fire ammo ability, because then they will do their best attack. I don't know what they will do if you don't use it, but believe they should use the fire ammo as casters. Okay, so we've placed our long-range distance units there. Then we will have our Murloc and Satyrs in one group. Because we want to waste them first. They will be the cannon fodder. So we have two units of Satyr Shadow Stalkers. They are basically the worst infantry troops. Besides the Murlocs, I believe they are really bad basic troops. Then we have the Satyr Betrayers. They are medium Satyr troops. They are bigger and stronger. So they are pretty good, but they are still medium. And the Murlocs, the Murloc Tidehunters, they are basic troops. Militia. Then we have actual Naga troops. We have the Myrmidons. They are, I believe, medium. We have two units of ambushers. We need to place the other one on the wall as well. So we could probably place them there. Okay, and we will group the ambushers into one group. And the sea color should be in one group as well. Okay, then we have the Naga infantry. So the Myrmidons are medium Naga infantry, and then we have some heavy Guardians of the Abyss Naga infantry. They are pretty good, but they are not their best heavy infantry, but they are better than the Myrmidons. Then we have some cavalry, the Snapdragon Light Cavalry of the Naga. They're only ordinary cavalry, that is a unit of many troops. I believe they have some other cavalry units, but they are all single unit entities, or like three in a unit, so three giants, for example, or three monsters, three turtles, etc. They are not an entire unit of 75 units, so to speak. Okay, so what about our heroes? So we have an enemy over there. They will probably station themselves here. In this settlement, there are always troops that try to reach the settlement here, and it's impossible, so they will get stuck here. And that's why it's a good idea to let our bodyguard... let's see here. Nayentus is a bodyguard of Royal Naga Royal Guard, but we have a unit here, Medusa Matriarchs, as a bodyguard. This general has such a bodyguard. Place them there. Lose formation. It didn't work. Here we'll do that when we start. We'll have fire ammunition on. I think we have two units of those. Yeah. Place this one here as well. Okay, lose formation, it didn't work. Okay, and they couldn't use the fire ammunition because this guy is the general of the battle. For some reason he's chosen over the Royal Guard general, because the Royal Guard general, Nayentus, had worse stats, I believe. Okay, so we will start the battle. Can have them on lose formation now, send the Hornet general. This unit will also be in loose formation. They will fire at will. They have very long range. These Medusa Matriarchs, which are now the General's Bodyguard of the Naga. In the past we used the Rat of Shara as the Bodyguard, the Melee Bodyguard, but I changed them to the Matriarchs. They made more sense. So the enemy to attack the wall soon. See, they have Night Elven Archers, Spearmen, some Mounted Night Elven Warriors, Medium Cavalry. These Archers have long distance too. They can fire from a very long range. Unlike our ambushers, they can't do that.
God save us.
I believe our sea callers are pretty good, but they can't reach the archers. So we need the enemy to move closer. That's why it's a good idea. I forgot should have placed a unit of Marlocks here to open the gate so they would charge. 14% dead already, what the fuck? If we lose this battle, I will replay it, because they had won this battle in the past. We've already lost a few of our sea callers. I haven't even seen them firing anything. Now they do. I want you to fire. I don't want you to just stand there doing nothing. They're supposed to use their long range attacks against the invader before they're all shut down. Fuck. I messed up this battle, because usually I would be able to stop them here. I forgot to move the infantry. The Marlocks arrive here in time, but they can't hold for long. They are just militia. Need our satyrs to join the fight. And our myrmidons. Sound the horn again. General. Sir. Marlocks are tide hunters with long spears. They're the best Marlock unit we can have. Some of the satyrs came from this side, okay. So yeah, we'll send all the satyrs first. And of course our Medusa Matriarchs can fire them too. It's important that we waste our satyrs and Marlocks first. Before wasting our
praise to our Lord.
Myrmidons.
Our men have slain the enemy general. Now his
one
men
of the generals
died.
Captain Heralat on the captain. Okay. Even sent in some Knightelven archers in Lee. So yeah, our ranged units on the walls can be pretty effective. I believe they killed quite a few of them before they even fired. I'm disappointed. In the past we could like obliterate them from the walls. Some of our sea callers are doing that. But they should have done that from the start. Because otherwise they will overwhelm us in Lee. I mean, if all of them had fired at once before they took them down, I mean, many of them have been killed. I'm disappointed. If they win, we will have to replay. Still have the Naga Matriarchs firing giant arrows at them. Okay, but I want my melee infantry to charge. Medusa Matriarchs are pretty OP, but they're supposed to kill these guys. Some of them are doing that good. Don't like to lose this battle. I wouldn't accept it, because I've already won it, and it feels wrong to lose something I've already won in the past. They will also need to go through our infantry. Problem is that they have the numbers. Our range units didn't do a good job. Did kill some of them, but far from enough. Seem to have taken out many of their dryads and archers here. So I had three armies attacking and one fully sized defensive army. So it's four armies in the battle. They even have the keepers of the grove here. really dangerous unit. We wanted to kill off as soon as possible. I believe in the previous battle, they recorded for Twitch, I believe they were killed by the range units before they even entered the city. Good that we have some range units backing us up. We already sent in the Myrmidons too. Some of the units are retreating. The medium stuff, the spearmen. No, they are not retreating, they are just moving constantly. Throwing in more troops into the city, killed our Myrmidons on the walls and our Seacallers. No, some of the Seacallers are still alive. But I'm really disappointed in them. We've killed 40% and they've killed 49%. They might actually win. Okay, so we'll see how it will go. Because we need to also defeat their armies outside. It's not enough to stop the invasion force. We also don't want to accept a defeat in this location, because they have three important generals here, and especially Nagentus, which is a unique Naga Royal Guard general with his own unique strat-model and battle-model that they I don't want to lose this soon in the campaign. It will be difficult to defend against everyone in Kalimdor. I think it would be a good idea to retreat from Kalimdor and abandon all the areas there and just move everyone to Nordrun to fight in Nordrun. Might be a good idea. I almost killed all their firbolgs here. Not all of them, but a big number of them. Huge chunk of them. Big chunk of firbolgs. Okay. Still have some keepers of the grow alive. One at least. More than one. We didn't use the immersion tool because I wanted to control the army without zooming in the general here. We would probably use it if the general was under threat of being killed, but I don't think that will happen. Riots here, throwing javelins, even more troops coming. Moonstrikers, so armored archers pretty much, and then they have the firbolgs are finally about to enter. This battle went much better for the enemy. Fortunately we have the bodyguard that can kill them here en masse. I believe they will win against the satyrs. Myrmidons have already started to replace the satyrs here. So the elven archers, they have, knight elven archers, they have very long range too. They probably killed some of our bodyguard units. Put the bodyguard in lose formation and use the special ability Warcry. How is it looking over here? Most of their firbolgs have been killed. I believe they are tricked that they can go this way, so they just stand here. There are easy targets for our matriarchs. So that's good that we have killed most of their firbolgs without them entering the city. We have sent in the rest. Even some. That one of the militia units, it might be, or an officer, it's probably their general of that army. They had three armies, so they have three captains, or yeah, I believe it's three captains. They didn't have the general scenarios in the battle. We should be able to win against the satyrs. Maybe not. We are killing many of them with the Medusa matriarchs. The right thing to place them in loose formation because they can't kill them with the Night Elven archers.
My lord, only half our force remains.
Send in the rest of the infantry now. We have 75 cavalry units too. Let's send them in as well. The snapdragons, wherever they are, they're over here. Send them in now. They're light cavalry. Like dogs, animal handler units based on elephants. That's why they crashed on Windows 10 without the tool. Okay. Have some druids there too. Some of them have transformed into birds. So our cavalry will aid our satyr betrayers. Send in our guardians of the abyss too. We had quite a few. It's better that they aid in the fight than if they were to be just killed from afar by the Night Elven archers. We're afraid they would be shot down instead without aiding in the battle. So the snapdragons have joined the fight. They're not that good, but they are cavalry. So it's better that they join in the fight than that they just stand there and die from arrows or something. Guardians of the Abyss have joined. The snapdragons are light cavalry, so they will still be able to do some damage to their infantry. They are not very hardy, they will easily kill by anything.
Praise to our lord.
Better than their basic infantry. Okay. They're good at hunting down fleeing enemies too. Captain Machiel of the Night Elves died in battle, fell in battle. Our Medusa matriarchs are still firing on them. Very good. Hope they won't hit any of our own troops. Sent in some more of their riots. So this issue here is not a bug. Of course, in this game, the upper bodies are riders and the lower bodies are the horse. So they had to be separated like this. They look good in certain positions, but of course you can't have Kentars in the game without separating the body from the horse, so to speak. That's why they look blitzed when they move. It's the game we aren't intended for Kentars. We almost defeated their Furbolg Maulers. Okay, I think it's time to charge forward with our myrmidons. I don't want my infantry to just be shot at there. Do nothing. We've lost our unit of snapdragons. They fall. All of them have been killed. Sent in their moonstrikers in Lee. It would be good to have all the armies in one front. It's a problem too that the Blood Elves have like 53,000 in minus in economy because they had two good troops at the start. And even if we spent them, they still managed to become indebted. It would be hard to turn that around. It would be difficult to get them back to plus. Spend their armies. We can't just delete the armies in order and they are needed, otherwise we will be crushed and in the East Kingdoms too, we can't just delete them. It's better to use them.
Praise the Almighty! Our enemy has lost his stomach to fight. We must push our advantage.
Okay. I think it's time to move troops to the gate. They have some broken riots here. They fled with the Furbolg Maulers. They are still sending in some riots to harass our troops. Guardians of the Abyss are easily handling them. Okay, the situation outside. They had an entire army here. Managed to kill some of them with our ranged units.
The enemy flees the battle. Run down.
Their melee cavalry died. They're fleeing with some firebolts. So one army is pretty much defeated. This army should also be pretty much defeated. We killed pretty much everyone. Okay, so we are slightly leading the balance of power meter. Percentage allies kill 83%, percentage enemies kill 77%. They are leading in percentage too. The balance of forces is counting as evenly matched. Okay, they have some armies over here, and I believe they are more than what we can see. When we get nearer to this area, we will see more troops. I'm pretty sure of that. They might be too strong. We'll see. We seem to have finally won inside of the settlement. I can say that we had way more survivors when I played this battle the last time, because we killed way more from the walls. And we only have two Seacrawlers alive. They're still firing from the walls. Let's group this, all these troops into one group. Move this. Troops up. Can be in loose formation. Fast forward. elite troops to gather at one spot before ordering them to attack. They're fighting here. Some archers. Yeah, the Naga are pretty big. They're tall. They're broken now. Good. So we need our troops to gather over here. Yeah, we have way more troops alive. I played this the last time. But we'll still try to win. I can say that the sea callers did a worse job this time. That's why we lost more infantry. Previous battle, I believe, the sea callers killed way more of the enemy, so the infantry had bigger numbers at this point in the battle. Had more than one unit that was at full size. I believe we had lost all the satyrs and murlocs and such, but we had all the sea callers pretty much and the snapdragons, but we had way more guardians of the abyss alive. Now I lost an entire unit of guardians of the abyss. Lost quite a few. So the Night Elves, they will be able to send more armies our way. I think we need to take our general and try to reach Eldaret. Where Ilden Stormrage is with his army, and then try to move to Northrend both armies. Point holding any area in Kalimdor. Maybe we can return to it later. Together with the Blood Elves or something. It will be too difficult to fight the Scourge and the Night Elves. It's better to move all the troops to Northrend and fight the Scourge. Then when Northrend has been conquered, take Kalimdor. With the help of the Blood Elves. Blood Elves too should probably move out of Eastern Kingdoms, but they need to have some armies there, at least one, to hold their capital. There are too many factions in Eastern Kingdoms too. You can't just move away from there, then they will easily conquer the Blood Elven cities. Okay. Okay, it's time to attack. Let's pause the game. So we have some cavalry here, even long ranged cavalry, the hunter says. Guardians of the Abyss will be sent against their melee cavalry. By the way, I want them in loose formation. Okay, we'll move the big infantry first. Then when they spawn, the smaller infantry we will move them to. Maybe we should still order them to attack now. No, they are too fast, so there's we'll wait with that. Send the big guys first, as they are more suitable to fight the cavalry. I believe other troops are hiding. They have can hide anywhere attribute. So the Night Elves can hide anywhere. That's why when we get close to the cavalry, they will spawn a bunch of infantry, I believe. Then we'll send the rest of the troops against them. Send out the sea callers too. Remember that I used the immersion mode previously in this battle. It was pretty epic. We had like 3 or 4 of these remaining. It's because our sea callers slayed like most of their troops before they even entered the city. Now unfortunately these guys had to handle them. So we only have one unit that is almost a full sized unit. Ah, here they come. They're sending 40 hunters. Okay. Send this unit against hunters. Then we have the rest of the troops. Bunch of infantry troops. Let's see here. 22, 66. Send this unit against their cavalry. This one too against cavalry. Send some infantry. The ranged units against their infantry. They are too few to be able to win. Send the satyrs. Fire their hunters is skirmisher cavalry. Okay, so we will continue to fire on them. I mean, march on them. As we are using infantry. They are firing on us. Okay. Problem is, they will probably move away when we get close. Yeah, cavalry. So let's attack their melee cavalry then. Before they take us out. We already managed to kill all of these. I don't like this. Okay, let's sound the horn. We'll send out our generals too. Ah, they are in melee now. That's not good. Here, no more arrows. Laid a bunch of our troops here. We might lose. We're leading with 10%. Kill them. So our Myrmidons. No. Guardians of the Abyss, actually. They are fighting their cavalry. They will probably win. We are too few, they killed too many. And they were running towards them. The Naga, they are notoriously slow. Slowest faction in the game. Slow on land. Look how many they killed before they even reached the actual enemy. One of the Medusa Matriarchs still have arrows, we will use that one against their huntresses. They only had 2 Myrmidons, they will attack these guys. They were easily handled by the enemy. Satyrs are defeated. The Guardians of the Abyss are about to be defeated too. At least they put up some fighting. They put up a fight, but they were too few to handle their cavalry. So they've killed 94% and we've killed 79%. Medusa matriarchs to join in. Here's the general. They are not ranged. Okay, we place them here then. They count as infantry. Because they have no arrows left. Elves did manage to kill quite a few of our Medusa matriarchs at the center too. Yeah, they killed, as I fear, they killed a bunch of our Guardians of the Abyss before they even reached the fighting. I sent them in too late. And they also killed some of our matriarchs. That's because I fucked up. Not only did the ranged units, the sea callers, not fire in the beginning, It was like the AI's fault, because they were supposed to fire, and I have no idea why they didn't. In the previous battles they did, they had fired will on, but still didn't fire. So that was the fault of the AI, that they didn't fire, so the more enemies than what happened previously managed to enter the city. But then I screwed up myself by... I fucked up myself by not placing my infantry here, like I did in the previous battles. Enabling the enemy to reach this area so that they could reach my matriarchs and troops that were stationed here with their archers. I believe the archers couldn't reach them when they were over here.
Our men have slain the enemy general.
Oh, an enemy general has been killed. They sent in Lee infantry here now. I just hope that our infantry isn't bugged, so they will crash in melee or something. If they are, we will crash, and then we crashed. Yeah, we will have to replay this battle. Hello, Mr. Neon here. We're back in the beginning of the battle. We crashed, so it's either the Naga matriarchs who can't fight in melee, or it's the Naga Royal Guard. I believe it's the Naga Royal Guard. So actually, I believe it's a case of the bodyguard unit, I believe, can fight in melee. The problem is the general, because the ordinary general is a Naga matriarch, Medusa matriarch, and they ranged, so that causes this unit to crash whenever he is in a melee fight, which is a shame. The only way to solve this is to use to not use this model as the general here, I believe. Could probably fix it if we used the matriarchs as the bodyguard, but I'm not sure that would work either, because this model in use by the general do not share the long range attack with the Medusa matriarchs. But here he has a bodyguard of the Naga Royal Guard, and he's still CTD. So I suspect that it's the general crashing the Yuntus himself, and it's because the game wants him to be a Medusa matriarch, but instead he is a Naga Royal Guard without a ranged attack. I believe that's the cause of the crash. and changing the bodyguard to a Medusa Matriarch bodyguard might solve it, but I'm not sure. Might crash anyway. And I want him to be this guy. I believe it that Burning Legion, the Dreadlords, had the same issue when they had the bodyguard of... I believe the Dreadlord General... Dreadlord General would crash in melee when he had a Wrathguard bodyguard, smaller unit, because the Dreadlord was ranged and the Wrathguard wasn't. But when I changed the bodyguard into the same unit, a Dreadlord, then it worked. The problem is that it was the generic general for and bodyguard for the Burning Legion. But here, the Naga Royal Guard are just temporary, so I guess we can't have Nagentus as his own custom general without the game crashing. With Burning Legion, I believe I have Castrogal. He's not that different from a Red Lord. Yeah, he's still melee. So I don't really know why he isn't crashing. He had problems, I believe, attacking in melee. But he didn't crash like this guy. Okay, let's place all the units in on the wall again. This time we'll place our... Oh, that's the wrong unit. Didn't look closely enough. Okay, we selected the wrong unit. I selected a Guardian of the Abyss unit and I wanted to select the Sea Callers. So we'll select the Sea Callers. Should have fire ammunition on. This time I hope they will actually use their ranged attacks and won't just stand there doing nothing. We might be unfortunate this time as well. As for the generals, I want our Medusa Matriarchs to stand ready to fire here against the Furbolgs when they arrive there. Fire ammunition on. Same with these guys, they can stand at the same place. Okay, another infantry. We won't do the same mistake this time. So we place our worst infantry in one group. Our Satyrs. The Myrmidons. The Murlocs. I think the Murlocs should be stationed here. Problem moving them, I see. Okay, I can't. Then we'll move them immediately. There. Everyone hurry up and get there as soon as possible. The cavalry too. Hurry up there. This time the Sea Callers did what they should have done in the previous battle. Look at this. They have long range. Sea Callers. Their Keepers of the Grove can kill them. Svats. Lost quite a few to those projectiles. They also have some Dryads throwing javelins here. Especially the Keeper of the Grove. Druids have the same projectile as the Keepers, but they are not as dangerous because they are not cavalry. Okay, so they have some Knight Elven archers firing too. Come on, Sea Callers, fire more of your projectiles. Don't just stand there doing nothing. They did a good job in the beginning. They want them to continue to fire. They seem to have a lot of Knight Elven archers there to kill. Here comes our army. To place them all in loose formation, so they are harder to kill by their Knight Elven. Move back, soldiers. I don't want you to just leave the settlement, idiots. I don't know where they moved out of the city like this. Must be idiots. Okay. That never happened previously. Where are we? Move back in, what the fuck? They are idiots again. And now they lost a lot of troops thanks to those fucking keepers of the grove. So our archers did a much better job this time, but my infantry was fucking idiotic. They went out and got themselves killed. Sorry, but we can't accept this. We will have to replay. We need to play it like I did in the past. I believe I did exactly the same with the ranged units like we did here. But when it came to the infantry, I don't believe I moved everyone up. I believe I moved one unit of Marlocks up to open the gate, and then they sent in their infantry. And then after that, I pulled up the other infantry. If we need to do that. So that a lot of their infantry will be killed by our ranged units when they move towards the gate, and so that the battle will be fought further away from this, from the actual plaza of the settlement. But I don't want my troops to actually leave the city like what happened in the battle just so, because that just sucks. Okay, see you soon. Alright, so the battle is starting. Our ranged units have finally started to attack. We'll send up the Murlocs. Send them here so they won't exit. We will place all our infantry in loose formation so they are not easily killed by the horrible ranged units of the Night Elves. Don't want that. This unit shouldn't be in the army, of course. Place it wrongly. Let's move forward the Snapdragon Cavalry too. So our sea callers are massacring the enemy. It's good. Killing them. Have their Night Elven archers here. Massacred. Even as some moon strikers, they seem to have longer range than the archers and better armor. They even have some druids of the Talon. I believe their projectile is the same as the keepers of the grove, so it's important to kill them. We want to kill them as soon as possible. By the way, the projectile of the sea callers can change color. It can be blue and it can be green. So sometimes it's green and sometimes it's blue. Forward our troops here. Let's move the Murlocs forward so they will start using their actual infantry. We can massacre them before we have lost our long range units here. I want the Murlocs to open the gate. Hurry up. Yeah, we did a much better job this time. Yeah, their druids can't shoot that dangerous green projectile. Just like the keepers of the grove. It's really deadly. So we'll place our troops here. Our infantry will move up there. Including the snapdragons will move back. They will steamroll us soon. We'll sacrifice our Murlocs here. It's fine that they are in at that location. Let's place them in guard mode so they won't move out. Our sea callers are firing upon them as they are running away here. Okay, so now I just want their army to enter Here comes the dryads. Had quite a few dryads. Here comes their horrible unit. Keepers of the Grove. I would like my sea caller to take out their keepers of the Grove. Let's group them. Stop firing. Attack their keepers of the grow. You can attack this unit, of course, and you guys. Seems I lost quite a few. The fuck are my fuck? Did I have them selected? So now we will probably end up dying again here. Kill as many as you can, then. The keepers of the Grove. I don't know why they moved out. We're totally idiots. I might, in the worst case, now need to replay again. We lost 35%. They lost 12%. I didn't want them to move out of the city like that. They also have druids. Idiots. This settlement is problematic because it's hard for the units to move in it. Whenever you click on them to move into the city, they move out instead and don't follow the path. They have a hard time moving.
The walls are no longer ours. The enemy has
so I have clicked on them to move here, not to move out. Fire on anyone you want now. 28, 27, 31. Massacring this unit of Night Elven volunteers at least, but it's a sucky militia unit. Problem is that they could kill the keepers of the Grove. The next time I replay it, I will place all the at least one unit here so they can fire on the keepers there. I only had the Naga Amateurs here, unfortunately. But I think this battle went better than the last one where they killed my infantry. With the keepers of the Grove, without me even getting to them. Now they enter the city. Kill them in melee. Come on now. What the fuck? Now move here. Need you to kill them. As soon as possible. And they shouldn't get that close to the units at the center either. Send in the unit of Shadowland Guardians there. Still have some troops fighting here. Snapdragons were still alive. Send our Guardians of the Abyss and the Myrmidons there too. Because we will need it. We lost most of our Satyrs. This battle still went way worse than the second battle and the first battle. We killed 25%, they killed 55%. Even sure it went better than the last battle. where we fought until the end almost. Because of a crash. Crashed when the Naga Royal Guard entered melee. Because they were the bodyguard unit. Okay. My battles do not go as well as they did previously. It's like it went much worse this time and then the last time and the one before that. What about the armies over here? Far from killed. Idiots. They are not even firing. They're supposed to fire at will. So I forgot to play them at fire at will. Seem to have forgotten to place them in fire at will mode. Can't use the Royal Guard because it will crash. Place them all the way over here. Well, they are attacking the fireballs over here. They come with the furbolgs again. Archers are firing on our Naga Medusa Matriarchs. The Medusa Matriarchs. Yeah. They started to move. could. If they all storm the city now. Usually we would manage to kill more of them. Well, they're probably going for the city. Continue to harass them as long as we can. Let's turn our attention towards the archers here. They are dangerous. Killing a lot of our troops. Matriarchs. Can we kill 60% or kill 65%? The key was to kill purples. I listened in a unit of triads. They also have moon strikers there in the back. I want to use the triads probably in the lane. It's a cool settlement, but it's annoying when they move out of the city and such. When you don't want them to move out. Okay, now they sent in more troops, including archers. So I need to attack them with our Medusa Matriarchs. Infantry is already upon them, but they sent in the Furbolgs now too. I believe this is the final wave of the infantry they will send into the city. So if I played the third person mod and controlled Nagentus, then we would need to keep him out of the battle as soon as he is in a lethal crash. But I believe his bodyguard can fight, not him though. That's still a problem. Because it can be difficult sometimes to avoid a melee fight with a general. Good, our Medusa Matriarchs are helping now. I believe they still have the final army over here. when we move here, they will have the two symphony units that we saw previously. We need to defeat, that's a problem. She might not win this time either. We're unlucky. Let's see. These are Medusa Matterhorns are killing off their archers here. Furball Maulers, they're mercenaries of the Night Elves, but they can be hired by anyone in that region, I believe. They are mercenaries in Night Elven lands. In lore, they are friendly to the Night Elves, but of course in this game, anyone can recruit them if they are in the right region. That's why I didn't make every rebel unit into a mercenary, because it would be weird to have certain units in certain armies. They still wanted some mercenaries in the mod, so the Furbolgs made sense. They started to run. Furbolg Maulers are retreating. Very good. There, the Night Elven archers broke. They have another unit here. Yeah. We will have to break as well. Some of the Furbolg Maulers are still fighting. I just don't want to kill my own troops, so I'm a little bit worried here. We should stop firing now. There are not that many. Just kill their Night Elven archers. They are very close. Kill them in melee. They can't continue to fire. Fucking entire new unit throwed up. Night Elven archers. Heal them. As soon as possible.
Almighty, our enemy has lost his stomach to fight. We must push our...
Okay, the general died, Captain Mathiel. Okay, building captured. Scared him out of the settlement. There are way more troops this time. Move everyone over here. About their troops, they are retreating there, which is good. They still have a cavalry unit here, which isn't good. We'll attack them with the Naga matriarchs. Medusa Matriarchs. Well, this army is moving the beast. With way more numbers this time. After the battle. The deranged units can still take them out. Those huntresses are still a threat. We lost all of our sea callers. Only have two of the ambushers still alive. These guys have ammo still, so we can use them. Now they didn't waste a lot of ammo because this time I were smarter and used them better. I might actually not want them to attack that unit. Let's stop moving. Move all our infantry against this cavalry unit and overwhelm them. Doesn't matter if we have to waste them on the cavalry there. Maybe we'll not move the satyrs or the myrmidons. We'll move the guardians of the abyss against them. So the Hornet General can move out the ambushers. And our matriarchs could move up here. I want them to handle the actual huntresses over there. Still hopefully we can win this. Balance of power is to our advantage. Victory statistic possibility, percentage enemies killed 78% and percentage allies killed 72%. So we could still win. We just need to clean up this unit of mounted Night Elven warriors. We have a captain here too. Night Elven sentinel captain. The captain of that army. Guardians of the Abyss, they are pretty good against that type of unit. Of course the Naga Royal Guard would have been even better. But I don't dare using them due to the crash. If I ever am gonna use them, then we need to use the immersion mode so we can attack the unit without attacking it, the actual general. What are they doing? Oh fuck, they have a druid unit here! Kill them, Karthik, before they fire at you. Need to kill that druid unit first. Kill the druid, what the fuck? I can't have that. We need to kill the druid even with our ranged unit. They are really dangerous if they fire their projectiles. They can kill all my infantry.
We have lost half of our men.
What are you doing? Fight! For God's sake! Yeah, they have a problem moving in this battlefield. These guys don't even want to move. Close formation then. Just attack. As long as they are in melee, we don't need to use our ranged units. So we sent in the satyrs as well. So we can't allow them to ever fire at us. Good. Guardians of the Abyss are fighting in melee now. waste the weaker troops first, but we will try to use the Guardians against their cavalry. They took out an entire unit. Guardians of the Abyss, that's not good. Actually, my range units could take care of their cavalry. Right, we are firing on them right now. This unit. I do some matriarchs. They are wavering. Very good. Broken, maybe. Okay, we'll move our infantry. We'll move the. I'll do some matriarchs first to this spot. They are more important over there. They're still fighting the druids here, so we need to let them do that. The druids are all dead. They even have some cavalry here now. Three. Let's fast forward. One druid, he died. So their captain will fall too. Okay, he died.
Our men have slain the enemy generals.
Captain Herolat dead. Good, their druid is dead. And their captain. Excuse me. Let's move the infantry over here. Move the general to fire against their huntresses. Horn, general. Actually, I changed my mind. They will stop moving. Need to keep an eye over here so they don't start moving before we're ready. We'll probably attack the huntresses soon. We just need our infantry a little bit closer. Want the infantry to be closer to our matriarchs. It's a little bit laggy when we use the fast forward because of the settlement. Some custom settlements can have that effect. Game, especially when we have a lot of bodies and troops too. But we will let the army move up. It doesn't lag when we have normal. of speed on. Or even slightly maybe, but we will use normal speed then. Naga are so slow, that's the problem. Ready. Move them there. First unit general to attack their huntresses from afar. Second unit can also attack that unit. Then the ambushers too. The guardians of the abyss can attack their cavalry. Mounted elven warriors. The rest will come later and fight their infantry. Should be visible soon. Now they became visible. Let's pause the game. I'm sure we can attack that unit instead. And the Myrmidons. Then we have another unit that can be attacked by the Satyr Betrayers. And another one can attack that one. Okay. Can slow down the game. Kill a few of the huntresses with our matriarchs, which is very good. Good. Killing quite a few. Hope they can fight in melee. Don't think it was them crashing. If it was, we will have to, you know, out to win this battle. I have won it before without I did record, but it was for Twitch. So yeah, if it's E3 again, I will out to win the battle. Because I count this battle as already won. I just wanted to have a new video.
Lord, our men have slain the enemy general. Now his men will lose heart.
General's dead, Captain Kael'Thas, the final Night Elven army. This battle.
Our men are winning the battle.
Your huntresses look like these, they're pretty cool looking. Look like the ones from Warcraft 3. Fan made unit.
Lord protect us, our general lies slain
upon
the battle.
They attacked my matriarch, the mounted warriors. All of Kael'Thas fell in battle in that charge. The Mountain Knight Mountain Knight Elven warriors. Yeah. Should have another one. Should attack that unit of mounted cavalry. We'll send forth the Guardians of the Abyss. They can't reach our final unit because we lost an entire unit there of Medusa Matriarchs that could have done well against them in from afar. We'll use this unit instead. Ah, the real general of the battle, the best one. The one with the horn still alive. He can't use fire ammunition, that's it. They are still pretty good, these arrows. They are ballista arrows, bigger arrows. Because they have giant bows, it made sense. For them to have giant arrows as well. Slay their cavalry. Okay, now you can slay the final unit. They have an entire unit over there. Do you want to kill? Don't need loose formation anymore. It's only infantry cavalry left. One unit of satyrs remaining. A general will take care of their cavalry. Sound the horn. General. Preparing to fire.
In our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted, victory will be ours.
Now they are about to fire upon the mounted elven warriors, mounted knight elven warriors. Let's see how many they kill in one volley. Kill quite a few. If they're lucky, they won't even move. Or they will move and it's too late. Already killed like half the unit. Our guardians of the abyss are fighting over here against the Night Elven warriors. They had at least 3 units of Night Elven warriors, 4 actually.
Unwise to praise the day.
Remnant cavalry over there.
Our men are winning the
battle. They're stupid and didn't
move.
Yeah, probably had problems moving. That was good. Almost all of them are dead now. So if the game won't crash, then we'll win this battle. Fair and square. I think it's time for our general to move towards this unit instead, as it's moving. Kill that. Kill those 3 mounted tigers. Yeah, all of them are dead. We've already killed these guys, okay. Now let's kill this unit of swordsmen.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
They have 125. Now they lost quite a few in that volley. Total, they have lost 84% of the army defending, and they have lost 90% of their 3 armies. Battle would be pretty long, and also we tried to play it 2 times prior to this battle too. It's the 3rd try during this episode. Still think I will finish the turn and play another time with Blood Elves too. Maybe we'll end the episode at the start of the next battle. Which is the... might be the battle of the Tuskar village.
To praise the day before
the Naga
are
laying siege to.
Our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Or it might be the battle against the man.
The enemy are badly bloodied.
On the field.
They have lost half their men.
They're still firing upon them. We killed an entire unit with the bodyguard. They didn't do anything but stand here. We killed 2 units like that. Just finish them off now. have any ammunition. Okay, they're out of ammo. I don't want to risk a CTD by using them in melee, in case it was the matter was causing it. Not in this battle at least, we'll try that in another battle. With the matriarchs to make sure that they are not the ones. But I don't think so, I believe that they have been in melee before. And that they didn't crash. Now they are fighting the Guardians of the Abyss. They have 63 Guardians of the Abyss versus 59 Night Elven Warriors. We should win that fight, and here we have 81 Guardians of the Abyss against 47. Should win here too. Here we have 57 Myrmidons against 88 Night Elven Warriors. We might lose this fight actually. They are both weaker than the Guardians and smaller, and actually fewer in numbers. It doesn't matter if we lose the Myrmidons. Rather lose them than waste more of my guardians. Yeah. So we'll waste that entire unit and we will finish them off with the guardians. What else do we have? We have a unit of Naga ambushers. Let's try to move them over here. They are stuck on the walls. And we have the Naga matriarchs and their royal guard. We can't use the royal guard. Clearly winning there. Here too. But it was more even in this fight. Night Elves are not bad, they are pretty good, their troops. Three, there were five more units over there. Looking good. And we'll see a finishing move against that knight. Eight remaining. 30 here. On this front it should be to their advantage. 74 versus 43 Myrmidons. Face them face on in a big line.
If we remain true,
1 versus 73.
Victory will be ours.
So the Myrmidons are using the civilian animation from Hyrule to the War. Like many of the humanoid militias, including the Night Elven ones. That's why they move around a bit. Now they will fight in more of a line, which is good. I believe the Night Elves will win against the Myrmidons. I expect the Myrmidons to lose the battle. They didn't have the numerical advantage. I believe quality wise we have 14 attack and 5 charge bonus. In total we have 19 attack and 13 defense. Well, the enemy has 15 attack and 16 defense. They have better defense and we have better attack. Okay. 9 Night Elves, while we have 67 Guardians of the Abyss, and here they are down to 16 Night Elves, and we have 40 Guardians of the Abyss, so we'll win both those rounds. I believe they won here in a moment or so. We don't have much of an army anymore. Let's see, let's just let the Myrmidons fight to the death here. And we can move up behind them. We'll be prepared to interfere there. So we have 65 remaining of the Guardians of the Abyss, and currently 24 Myrmidons fighting 55 of their Night Elven warriors. They will win the fight. We will kill them off here. We have 8 remaining. We have 39. They won. We will attack the final units of 5 swordsmen over here. This unit. It'll be over very soon. Only one remaining. Good. Now attack those 5 units. So 39 versus 5 we have already won. But this fight, we have 19 Myrmidons fighting 49 Night Elven warriors at the moment. They will manage to cut down every one of them. We have 12 remaining now. Unit, march. What happened over here? Is the battle over?
The battle is in our favor. If we remain,
they are broken. Only 2 remaining.
Victory will be ours.
Send that unit towards the Night Elves over here. They will take a while until they get there. So maybe we'll manage to send these guys first. I don't know. They're still fighting the Myrmidons, but they are almost defeated. We only have 7 remaining now. So it's almost time to send in the Guardians of the Abyss into the final battle against this unit of Night Elven warriors. They have 43 here, still alive. Of course, we wanted to waste our worst unit first before sending in the Guardians, the Abyss. 37 over there and 65 over there. Another one died. The 37 first against their 43. They might kill them, I don't know. But this is the stats of a Guardian. 17 attack, 8 charge bonus. So in total they have 25 attack and 15 total defense. Okay. So they're way better than the Myrmidons. Only one Myrmidon remaining, he's dead. Just in time for these guys to charge. 37 Guardians of the Abyss. Thank you. took one down, that hit. He got back up on his snake feet. They have 35. Shit, they are winning against this unit. We still have a unit of 65 Guardians of the Abyss that will win otherwise. They might win against this unit. They have 23 versus their 32. Night Elves have very good stats. They're one of the strongest armies in the game. Naga are about the same, similar. Shit. They're slaughtering the Guardians of the Abyss.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Yeah, they will probably win this fight. But even so, we have more troops to send in, so we'll win the battle. Versus 25. Nine versus 22. They will probably break before they have all. Laggy when we have the camera pointing towards the city, but not otherwise. When we point towards the opposite direction of the city, then it won't at all. So the settlement is causing some minor lag. Yeah. Three remaining. Killed another one. Move on.
wise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Be a piece of cake to win against that ship. 99% enemies killed and 93% allies killed. The balance of power meter is clearly into our advantage. Another one died. The final guy died. Without retreating. The battle is over. Good job. Naga serpents. Okay, so the battle is finally over. And we have won. Let's see, 99%. It's saying that there is a unit alive here somewhere. Let's zoom out. It's also saying there are units over here. Ah, there's a cavalry unit over here. We'll attack them. Guardians of the Abyss, so they have 3, 4, 6, 7, so they have, as far as I can see, they have 9 units remaining. Cavalry units, which isn't good, but at least they are not ranged. They should be able to win. Should have a unit here too, according to the map. Let's hope it won't bug out and say that there is an enemy somewhere where it is. In some mods, or in Medieval 2 in general, if in certain battles, the game can say that there is an enemy somewhere, but there isn't. It could be a body of an enemy, but it still thinks it's alive, and you can't win without killing that unit. At least not when you don't have the timer on. Smoothie General over here. An enemy here somewhere. By the way, I forgot that it's possible to zoom out like this. You can see the settlement. We can also have the armory blink. Then all the enemies should blink too. Might be below the water. Oh, there is a unit here. Spearman. They are invisible. Need to kill them first. Let's fast forward. Spearmen, or whatever it was, warriors. It only lags when we have the camera against the settlement and have the fast forward on. Should show up soon. Here they are. So it was spearmen, Night Elven spearmen. 12 of them. Attack! What the fuck? Don't move away. One guy here. He will probably be killed. don't know why they have problems moving in this area. It's really annoying. Move away when I click on them to attack. So I will just station them here. Move the attack on the map. Fucking idiot. Move here then. Move behind them. Move straight through them. So now they will kill each other. Good. Our numbers should win us this battle. When they touch each other, they automatically attack because they're enemies.
The battle is in our favor. If we remain true and wholehearted,
the six remaining, we're 14 in the beginning. It's only the cavalry then. They are more dangerous. Good, the battle is over. These guys are broken, they will leave the battlefield. Here they have another unit. It is invisible. Let's move over there. The troops. Fast forward. Another invisible unit, I believe. So we'll send the troops there and clean up that unit too. Hopefully they aren't that many. I would be highly surprised if they were like druids or something. Yeah, this episode became very long. We'll finish the Naga turn and at the beginning of the next battle. Probably the battle against the Amani, it's the Blood Elves. So this will be like one episode, because I don't want episodes to be too long. And I believe I've played for over an hour, especially if we count the failed attempt as well. Let's attack this unit now. Ambushers finally reached this area too. We have 15 Night Elven warriors. Ah, but it's the wrong unit at the right here. We can move away a bit. Ambushers could probably attack. Finally got down from the walls. They're now attacking the enemy. Only two remaining. They killed at least two, three maybe. I think they were 15. There is one unit coming. But where are there's the larger force. 56 remaining. We lost 10, I believe, since the attack on that unit. Let's hurry up. It takes forever for them to march. 10 remaining. 9. They're finally here. 8 remaining.
Unit, move up. It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but
well, I would want to try and hold my area's cannon, but I believe it's too difficult. We will need to retreat. This army is pretty much depleted anyway. We need to get this army to Illidan. Maybe send a fleet there. These guys are dead. The two remaining. Lost one in the back. Remaining. Oh, he got up on his feet again. They have still two. They're died.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset. But our men are winning the battle.
That soon,
they
died.
A worthy victory.
Now it's just the cavalry. So you'll need to take care of. Hurry up. They had at least 9, I believe. 9 mounted Night Elven warriors. They might be able to kill a few of our troops. The carnage here. All the way up here. Sea colors killed a lot of the enemy. Then they kill everyone on the wall. And bloodbath here at the gate. Bloodbath inside. All the way over here. Even managed to kill some troops over here. And in the center. None for bodyguard died. For min Nagaroid bodyguard. Some of the enemy reached all the way over here. We're almost upon the enemy. We turned around. I believe they were charged. They didn't even charge us. Alright.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle.
Two remaining.
And forging a
one remaining.
Victory.
The battle is over in a second. And he died. Battle's over. Good job, Naga Serpents. We have won the battle. Okay, so this took a long time to do. Like I knew it would. Celebrating the victory there. So Warlord Kael'Thas survived, and Nagentus himself survived, but the third general of the Naga died. All the captains of the Night Elves died. And Warlord Kael'Thas had 1882 men. Actually, he had 1882 Naga and Satyrs and Murlocs. Okay, and we lost 1494. We have 388 remaining. Not enough to counterattack. Enemies killed. We killed 3617 of the Night Elves, Dryads, and Firbolgs. And then we killed 42 retreating enemies as well. enemy, they killed at least 1191, 492 and 75. So the one arm under Captain Mathiel with 1351 men only killed 75, that was very bad. Then Captain Kael'Thas of the Night Elves had 1532 men, lost 495, 37 remaining and killed only 492, not good either. Then Captain Heralat of the Night Elves had 915 men, they killed 1191. I believe one of the armies were the army with the fur book that we killed from afar mostly. And then the other one got slaughtered from the walls by our sea crawlers for the most part. And then, so I believe this army was the Furball army, and then this one must have been the other army with some good stuff. They killed 492, but they still lost a lot of troops to the sea crawlers. And then the final army is the one that did well during the beginning of the battle and the middle of the battle. Side of the settlement. Okay, the details, hard to read, I know, but not impossible. So we can see that we had some Myrmidons that killed 105 men, we had some Guardians of the Abyss that killed 343 men, Guardians that killed 359, and Guardians that killed 173. We had some Sea Callers. The Snapdragons only killed 10. Sadder Betrayer killed 269, pretty good. And Shadowstalkers killed 160, that's also good. Unit of Seacallers killed 105 enemies. Another one killed 140. And another one killed 134. Okay. Let's exit. So predictable, I knew you would come, and I see you brought the mighty Hellscream. His blood is mine, and is your whole. As is your whole, misbegotten race. Ah, so predictable, I knew you would come, and I see you brought the mighty Hellscream. His blood is mine, as is your whole, misbegotten race. Manor of the Destructor, General of the Burning Legion. Oh fuck, their final army attacked. In this battle, they didn't attack with all their armies. Scenarios had an army too, and he's attacking now. An entire army, and we only had remnants surviving the battle. Fuck, we lost the army. No, we're now controlling the Blood Elves, because I had clicked on the end turn. So the Naga are now once again under siege. By scenarios, we have poor relations with Lorder on the Blood Elves. We are once again in control of the Blood Elves now. Seems the Scourge is laying siege to Sulmashar. We have a unit of Spellbreakers. They have a smaller army. Come face me. It's not good. We'll have to aid. We'll let our army help us. They fled. Good. We'll destroy them. Execute. Can't attack them this time. Our assassin here can destroy something.
Fire shall consume the building and the evidence.
Succeeded. Good. Destroy their training grounds. Can't recruit or build anything. We have minus in profits. We are minus 51,952. We are laying siege to our capital that revolted. We could attack now, but we could also wait on our siege towers. I believe we will attack, but I don't know if we will play the battle now. Scourge is moving towards the city here with a huge force. But if we can't move to Tunkalu, it's just a village. They will steamroll this area. Can't hold it. This is a citadel. It's the most powerful settlement type, castle type. But unfortunately, the Scourge version of the castle, because this is the Scourge version, it's the same as Ice Crown. It's using the Shadow Temple from Hyrule Temple War, which is a settlement that suits the Scourge and Ice Crown, but doesn't have any walls or anything. They will just move in. And then there are like rooms where you fight, which fits a zombie faction, but this settlement, the Frostwall settlement, it's a walled settlement, so we can kill them from the walls. We have some mages, so I guess the best thing we could do is defend here, or try to reach the ships that I sent here somewhere. Yeah, we have a ship here. Hopefully it's blocking the Scourge from going here. I'm not sure.
Yes.
But we could try to retreat. Then we could be ambushed. I think we will defend against the Scourge. Or sally out, actually, and meet them. Actually, I want the army to be spent. They don't want to lose my general. Don't like the idea of losing my mages either. Do they have... I have some mages in the army too. I think all of these troops that are not mages should move out to face that army. The battlefield will improve our economy. Of course, not all of them. We could send out some of the cavalry too. Giants, of course.
Orders. Bringing our troops together.
So Halron Brightwing is a unique general. But I'd rather sacrifice him than the leader. It says King Kael'Thas, but he is prince. Okay. Could also send out Phoenix. Keep the mages here. 9, 12, and 9, and the bodyguard of Kael'Thas, of course. Okay.
Let me strike, my lord.
And this will be a big battle. They're mostly skeletons that are basic troops. Skeleton soldiers, skeleton spearmen, they are basic militia staff of the Scourge. Then they have undead surgeons, they are medium staff. And they have some banshees, but they are more like the sea callers, archer types, but mages, but they are stronger than the sea callers. So they are pretty dangerous, actually. Our army have some. We have a unit of archers, otherwise, we have mostly infantry and such. We have a unit of phoenixes. Actually, I believe the priests could join. And actually, I believe all of the troops can join.
Okay.
Well, Kael'Thas will stay in the city. So, balance of power. Army strength ratio 2 to 1. Scourge us as a backup force with some more infantry, including undead champions. Okay, we'll save here before the battle. And I think we could end the episode here, actually. So thank you for watching, and see you the next time. We haven't played this battle before, by the way. I had fought the other battle, but not this one. So we'll end here, and see you the next time. Bye.